Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rafe Gal. And this is Ori. I have been meaning to play this game for a while. I've been putting it off because it looked... A lot of the movement looked intimidating. And I know that that's probably not the case anymore so than with something like Hollow Knight. It's just my perception. This is a... what? Oh, apparently this is me. I don't think that's actually me. I think this is... just an interactive introduction. So yes, this is a... Metroidvania platformer. It is a fairly... it's a 2D game. It's fairly... well... I really like everything I've seen. I've watched a few speedruns of this, and I've also just... seen some screenshots, and the graphics have always just been extremely intriguing. It has a really unique aesthetic. It is adorable. And it is gorgeous. That really like watercolor feeling. The music is already really drawing me in. Although I will admit, this is way too something. Bright and happy. Say, I'm waiting for something to happen. I have heard that this is not a happy story. There's something really powerful, and it's really simple but powerful about having control, even just for little bits of that. where it makes it feel just that little bit more engaging. Okay. This is starting off on a great note. Oh, that foreground anime, or the enemy in the foreground. Looks like it's stalking, something stalking. Screw you, game. I knew this game was supposed to be sad, but I did not realize it started sad. For the record, this once again is requiring me to actually move. If I'm not holding down the button, it isn't working. Which is unique, especially considering that it's not actually just walking. The journey begins. Game save. This looks like it's the actual intro. The actual real beginning of the game, rather. Okay. This uses mouse and keyboard. So we're gonna see a good mix of those. If you see the mouse cursor on the screen, that's why. Oop. I should probably actually just follow directions and there for the time being. For that. Energy cell. You hold E to create a soul link and save your game. Okay, game saved. Nice. That was a thing that just happened. Story found what was lost. Okay, so every time we get experience, we get to level up the ability tree, it looks like. Allowing us reusing soul links to shorten, and shortens the cooldown timer. Most pickups now float to Ori. Shoot three flames before recharging. We're gonna start with this one because restoring health when you create a soul link seems like a good thing. This is probably our first ability. Probably an attack. Sin, the light and eyes of the spirit tree. I was lost in this glen when she loosened her grip. I can guide you on your journey if you allow me to come. But be still, can you hear that? They must have followed you here. Objective, find the spirit. Okay. We'll do that. Tab goes to the map. Oh. so that was, I had gotten that note about, or one of the options for the level up feather was 3 flames. It looks like you, right now I'm getting 2 per attack, basically. So I'm guessing that the attack up one gives you 3 instead. So that looks like it's, Okay. So we're gonna buy this because, once again, healing is good. And the ability to heal without requiring item drops and such is especially good. Shift to grab and move objects. Okay, nice. Keystones open spirit gates. Okay. I like how fast this game is just, like, once you get past the intro, it really just hands you a pile of stuff. So there's, okay, we know we need to get key runes, abilities, like, it just gave a whole pile there. Waiting for something bad. Looks like that needs... Yeah, so it looks like one per little... semicircle there. Oh, nice. So we want to go to the Hollow Grove. Let's try going left first here. This is a map stone, okay. There's a piece missing. Maybe if we find the map stone fragments, we can repair. Okay. Rune. I feel like I'm going to get stuck if I continue on this path, but okay. And I'm kind of right now wishing that I had taken that one that pulled stuff towards you, because I don't think I can get these right now. That's okay. Soul Link is ready. But I don't need health right now, so I don't want to do a Soul Link. Wall jump. This was a good decision to go here first. Map shard. Energy shell? Energy shell. Cell. Have the cost of charge flame, but we don't have charge flame yet. And regroup, which is this one. Okay. So that's probably going to be a power up we get later. Spirit Magnet. To watch most of my other runs, I like that efficiency and making sure that I'm getting all the stuff. See that sticking out there? The backgrounds in this are extremely interactive. By that I mean it's kind of hard to tell at certain times like that whether it's the foreground or the background. That's fine. But I'm assuming we can't break this, yeah. Okay. Neat. Need to pay more attention. Neat. Appstone. Nice. I'm guessing that means that now this will be easier to get back if we wanted to go up. Made a pretty good dent in that area, considering that we're not even supposed to be going to it yet. I'm guessing we actually do need to, but that's okay. So now we're gonna head up the other direction that was available. We're gonna do that to recover health. That's much going much better. A little more patience. Energy gates are sealed by spirits. If we connect enough energy shields, they'll open up. Okay. Where do you go through there, maybe? Doesn't really look like there is a spot where I go where you go through there necessarily. Supposed to grab the wall. Apparently I need to be slightly more active with it. Still kind of feeling out a lot of this. It's harder than it looks. I still feel like you should be able to get through there somehow. Still the same thing. Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about some of the, just the way the controls work. It doesn't feel as responsive as using a controller does for this type of game. Which is a little frustrating at times, but I feel like there's too many commands, and I like the mouse aspect of it. I'm sure I'll get used to it, and maybe it's just that I need a better keyboard. It's the Night of the Lights ceremony. It was our light that she hated. Okay. Wind? Yeah. Fire? Okay. Beyond the Spider Coves, that's lovely. I do like the way that this swamp kind of does its thing, or the swamp, the map kind of does its thing. So, shows where you're going, which is nice. Looks like I still have a lot over here that I might have been able to do. First area, but we just hit a save point. We also now have the ability to fast travel, which it's nice, which means we don't have to do this again. There's that little island that I said I bet there's a way to get there, and I'm not sure how. So I think what I'm gonna do is save here for now. And we will jump back down to the other well. And pick back up from here next time. Overall, I am liking it. It's not exactly what I was expecting as far as the controls go, which is good. I am still running into some problems with it, just from the, like I said, I'm just not feeling like it's quite as responsive, so I may actually just need to look into getting a different keyboard, because I have a cheapo keyboard that's kind of ancient, and I bet I could be more comfortable if I wasn't mashing on it quite so much. But who knows? So, hopefully you still enjoyed. If you are, please give me a like and subscribe. Check out the other content on my channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments. And as always, have a good one.